Welcome back to Selena's table and to my kitchen. Today we're going to do some freezer meals, some preparation for future days where I might be too busy to cook. So today we're going to make two cottage pies if we get the time. So they're a shepherd's pie but with beef mince. We're going to make three or four chicken marinade recipes, and they'll just sit in the freezer, and the rest of the components to finish the meal will be done the night that we eat them. I'm going to make some beef burger patties, some beef meatballs, and some chicken schnitzels. Thanks for watching today, and I hope you enjoy the video. So one of these recipes calls for yogurt, and I've just noticed that we are running low, so I'm going to get a batch of yogurt going in the instant pot. So I've just washed this out. And making yogurt is really easy. If you have an instant pot, it's just some yogurt and milk. I always use long life milk when I'm making yogurt because it's been heat treated. Because I only want to grow good bacteria, not any bad bacteria. And that's just the way I've always done it. So I'll use 2 liters of milk. And half a cup of yogurt. This is yogurt that I'd made in the past. So you can see how thick it becomes. So this has got all the active live cultures in it. We want about half a cup. So before I use all my yogurt, I always make sure I have enough to make another batch. And this will make plain Greek yogurt, and I also substitute our Greek yogurt for sour cream on things like tacos. And then we just want to whisk that together and pop it in the instant pot. It's going to sit in the background doing its thing. I'm going to clean this up and we'll get started on marinated chicken. The first one is Greek chicken.
Whenever I do these chicken marinade packs, I always put them in these large freezer Ziploc bags and I just label them.
Hold my bag like that and put what I need in it. But I did realize I've run out of lemon powder. I make lemon powder out of dehydrated lemon skins. These lemons have come from my trees. They're organic. So I dehydrate them in my food dehydrator. And then I just get a grinder. And this replaces things like lemon zest and makes a really strong lemon flavored powder that you could add in baking or in seasonings. I make lemon pepper using this. So I'm just going to quickly grind some lemon powder. If you don't have lemon powder, you could use just lemon zest. I just like the extra lemony flavor from the powder, and it uses up something that would otherwise go in the waste. All right, in this one, I don't remember these off by heart, so. Okay, in this one, we want some smoked paprika. 1 tablespoon. some ground coriander, another tablespoon. Some lemon, and I'm going to get a teaspoon of that. Lemon or lime, but that's why I use the lemon powder. Some salt, pepper, some garlic, good tablespoon, probably 4 cloves of garlic. Yogurt, we want about, I'm going to use all of this, it's probably a cup, maybe a cup and a quarter of yogurt. And then some herbs, we've got oregano, we've got mint, parsley, and we've got coriander. So I'm going to wash these and then we'll start chopping. I'm going to include the stalks.
So I would make these freezer packs at least every month, and normally I would make more than one of each of the flavors that I'm making today. I'm very low on freezer room at the moment, so I decided to just make one of each. But yes, normally I would make two, if not three, of each of these all at the one time, and it just really prepares for a much easier dinner in the nights to come.
Ready for chicken, which we will do in a minute. I'm just going to get all the bases done and then we'll work on the chicken. Next up, coconut lime. Salt and pepper, teaspoon of salt, pepper, coriander, lime, this one has cumin in it, so we'll just do a teaspoon, a mounded teaspoon. Of a cup, brown sugar, a can of coconut milk, some lime zest off these before I juice them. These are just little. You could use one large one or two little ones.
So I'm just going to add the juice of these limes as well. It would probably be one large lime or two small limes if you were wanting to replicate this recipe at home per pack. And in the same way that I made my lemon powder, you could also make a lime powder and add that if you wanted to.
Teriyaki. Start with olive oil. Pepper. Half a cup. Garlic. Ginger. About a tablespoon of each. And honey. Two tablespoons of honey. That one. Pesto ranch, and it calls for pesto. These are pesto that I made and froze into little discs. So we use two of them. I'm just waiting for my pesto to defrost. We'll get started on pesto ranch. I said I'd normally do two of each at least of these. It's just that my freezers are full. I'm only doing one.
So this is pesto that I've just defrosted in the microwave.
About a quarter of a cup of oil, salt, pepper, dill. I've got some parsley and a little bit of oregano there, so I'm going to use that. Onion powder, and garlic. Okay. some of these I want cut into strips, and some I want the chicken into pieces. So pesto ranch is pieces, teriyaki is strips, coconut lime is strips, and Greek chicken is pieces.
So I've used about 3.5 kilos of boneless, skinless chicken breast that included the tenderloins. I'm just going to cut these into pieces that I like the size of for my marinade packs, and with the other parts, I'll just do them into strips.
Pesto ranch chicken, I pop the whole bag, I defrost it, and then I'll put the whole bag into one of these and pop it in the oven, and we serve it just with vegetables on the side. When we do Greek chicken, I cook it in the same way, although you could cook it in a skillet, and I serve that with flatbread, lettuce, capsicum, fresh sides. When we do teriyaki chicken, I'll cook that in a wok with some fresh vegetables and serve it with rice. And when we do the coconut lime chicken, I'll cook it in a pot, more like a Dutch oven. And sometimes I'll add another can of coconut milk depending on how it looks at the time. And we basically just cook that over the stove and then add some vegetables to it and serve it with rice. So it kind of ends up being like a curry type dish. And in the morning, I'll just take one of these out of the freezer and set it in the fridge for the day so that I can finish cooking at night. And the beauty is that when it's defrosting in the fridge, it will be marinating my meat, and they are just delicious. All right, let me see. I'm going to get those three.
So the three breasts that I've just set aside there, I'm going to save those and do chicken schnitzels with them.
And this will feed our family of, well, we're a family of seven, but three of our family members, our children, have grown and left the nest. So there's all day, every day, there's four, but we always make enough for five or six so that there's enough for leftovers for lunches in the morning. And also because you just never know when those young adults will call in for dinner.
I have washed my hands really well before I actually did this step. So I'm going to squeeze out as much air as possible before I do up the little zip top. And then I'm going to give the chicken a nice a bit of a massage into the marinade.
Massage these so that they're covered in your marinades. And then get them flat. Another step and chop up all your vegetables and pop them in here with the teriyaki and the coconut lime, but I like to use what I have fresh on hand, but that is an extra thing you can do. I'm just going to put these on here to freeze. And that's one of our things done. I told you my freezer was full. There's one that I made the other day, frozen. And a freezer meal is in here already. So I'm going to have to find somewhere else to place them.
So what we'll do is we'll turn these leftover chickens into chicken schnitzel. So I have 3 chicken breasts left. Going to cut them in half lengthways. That's called butterflying, so that I get 6 chicken schnitzels. This in the dishwasher. Flour. And this is lemon pepper seasoning, made in the same way as those lemon peels, mixed with salt and pepper.
So to crumb this chicken, or anything that you want to crumb, you need to have 3 separate containers, one with a seasoned flour, one with an egg wash, which is egg and milk, and the third one is your breadcrumbs. I actually started this off with my flour on the wrong end. Now it's on the correct end. So you'll dip your chicken or your fish or whatever you're making in the flour, coat it really well, and then you want to dip it into the egg wash and then into the breadcrumb mix.
And then I have some papers that I'm going to pop these on.
So with this one hand, I'm going to only use it to touch the chicken, to dip it in the flour and into the egg wash, and then use the other hand in the breadcrumbs. That will keep the final product hand, so the breadcrumb hand, nice and clean, and you don't end up with gloopy breadcrumbs stuck to your clean hand. The other hand will get quite messy with the flour and the egg wash and going between the two, but that's okay because it doesn't touch the end result, which is the breadcrumb. I'm going to press these breadcrumbs in really quite firmly. These are homemade breadcrumbs I made them with some stale sourdough. Just processed them in a food processor, so they are a little bit bigger than a purchased breadcrumb. And I'll just continue working my way through these chicken breasts until they're all done. Now that they're all done, I'm just going to label my Ziploc freezer bag and place them all in there, and that will be another dish done.
Purpose of the paper is to stop them sticking to each other in the freezer. And that's just baking paper. You could also freeze them on a tray before putting them into the bag so that they were hard and frozen. These two with shepherd's pie, so we're going to get started on some mashed potato. I leave the skins on if I'm working with these pre-washed potatoes, but you can peel them if you want to. Three to 3.5 kilos of potato to do the two. I might have more, I might have enough to do three, but we'll see how we go.
So I'm just going to add some salt to these potatoes and let them boil, and I'll get started on the filling.
Got some herbs from the garden. Here I've got some parsley, thyme, rosemary, I've got a bunch of little tiny capsicum, I've got some celery, a leek, I'll grab a couple of onions and some carrots.
So I'm just going to chop some vegetables, a fine dice is a good size, and add them to my pot before I start sauteing them.
So I was going to say, when you do leek, you do need to check. As you can see, we have dirt in the layers. So I'm going to give that a good wash. Are our zucchinis we're growing this year. They're an Italian striped zucchini and they are so, so nice. And they've been growing really well. So I add as many vegetables as I can when I'm making, well, most wet dishes. That's what this is called, a wet dish, like a casserole or a spaghetti, just to get as many vegetables as we can into our body, but also because it bulks out the food in a healthy way, we don't have to use as much meat, which is getting more and more expensive. We do have an abundance of vegetables growing in our garden, and that is why we have an abundance growing in our garden, because we use so many. So it's a good way to use up even old vegetables you might have in the fridge, cooked in a sauce like this. Got a couple of mushrooms. So you can peel your mushrooms. Instead of washing them, you can peel them.
And the great thing about a cottage pie is that you can actually use whatever vegetables you like. You don't have to use the same ones that I've chosen to use today. You can use any that you have on hand.
I've got two onions. This pan is going to be full right to the top. I might even need a second one. I'm going to actually can up a whole bunch of these because I did pick a few kilos at a time. I needed space in the garden. So yes, they are small, but they are homegrown. And I am so thankful for them. So we're going to you probably want about 3 supermarket carrots, which is a lot. Probably equal to 1.5 to 2 regular sized capsicums. And what I like to do when I'm doing one of these freezer cook-up days is make dinner one of these things. So we will keep one of these cottage pies for dinner tonight. So dinner will be done and the rest will go in the freezer, whether we have one or two. I actually hope we only have one, because I am concerned as to where I'll put them. My freezers are full. We have a lot of things in there we need to process. A lot of frozen tomatoes, frozen chilies. We need to make some sauces. Some salsas. Because I only have one little freezer as well. In addition to my kitchen freezer. Okay. Oh, garlic. Probably 4 cloves. So while that is there, I'll chop these herbs.
So I have parsley, thyme and rosemary here that are fresh from the garden, but you could also use mixed dried herbs. And we're just going to saute these vegetables until they're nice and golden. And in a separate pan, I'm actually going to start the meat because there's just not enough room in this one.
Doing a couple for a freezer and your pan isn't big enough, feel free to split it. So we're going to do vegetables in the one that's in now, and I'll do a second one with the meat, and I'll make the sauce and the gravy in that, and then we'll just combine them before we put them in the pans. I'm going to move the vegetables up here. This one heated here so we can put our meat in that one.
So what I have here is 800 grams of beef mince. If you wanted to make shepherd's pie, you'd use lamb mince, but this is cottage pie, so it's beef mince. So you just want to brown this beef and stir it regularly so that it doesn't stick to the pan.
And then just pop them back in the pot. So I've just left them in the colander and they can just drain there. These are those fresh herbs that we chopped earlier. Some pepper. Salt.
Add some dried herbs. Some mixed greens. If you saw my beetroot harvesting video and pickling video, you would have seen that I dehydrate my beetroot leaves along with other green things like spinach. So I'm going to add just a couple of handfuls of what I call my super greens. You don't have to add these. You could add fresh spinach if you had it. Some Worcestershire sauce. Tomato paste. And now I'm just going to mix this. And then I'll add it. Our meat. I'm going to turn that down.
So this is beef gravy powder and water mixed together.
Add that.
So we're just going to bring this to a gentle simmer, and we may need to add a little more water. We'll just want to see consistency as it goes. We need to make sure there's enough gravy to cover all those vegetables.
Just one, or you had a larger pot than I do, you don't need to make them separate like this. You put them all in the one pot, but this is an easy way to make more and use what you have.
So I'm just mashing my potatoes with a hand mixer. We've got salt, pepper, and butter, and a little bit of milk in here.
These taste amazing individually, so this is going to be a really nice dinner. Going to get the meat out.
Because I made the meat and the vegetables separately, I'm just going to make sure I mix them really well so that it was the same as if they were made in the one pot at the same time. Once you've got the meat mixture smoothly placed in each of your pans, you want to take the creamy mashed potato and put it on top and then smooth it out. I like to decorate the top just with little swirly motions, but you can just leave it like this or mound it up, or you can swirl it down as well. And then we just top the top of the pie with some grated cheese. This is just tasty cheese that I grated earlier. And then we can wrap it up and pop it in the freezer.
I'm going to find room in the fridge for both of these. And then I'll freeze one tomorrow, I think. I'll freeze one later this afternoon. But these can go in the fridge.
So now I'm going to make a meatball mix, which is the same as my burger patty mix. So in this, I've got some ground beef. This is 3-star ground beef, so it's not the same ground beef that I use for things like lasagnas and spaghettis and the shepherd's pie that we just made. So to make preparation a little bit easier on these meatballs and the meat patties, I'm going to use this blender here. This is a food processor and a blender and a thermocooker all in one. So I'm just going to pop my vegetables in there. We've got onions and carrots and some herbs and some seasonings. some mushrooms, and we're just going to process this into a smooth paste.
Vegetables. You could do it with just onion and garlic and the spices. 2 to 3 cloves of garlic. I'm going to give that a good whiz up. Okay, that is a nice paste. And now we'll just assemble it all together. We will add some all-purpose seasoning. Two eggs.
I have also added breadcrumbs.
And then we're going to mix it. You can use your hands. I like gloves. I don't like having mints on my hands.
So I'm going to mix this together really well, giving it a squeeze and a massage as I go until it's all really well combined. And then I'm just going to pull out handful sized rounds and pat them into neat balls and press them flat to turn them into burger patties.
Some pre-cut paper.
Once I've made all of my burger patties, I'll pop them in the freezer. And for the meatballs, I'm just going to use this cookie scoop to place little mounds on this baking tray. And then once I've scooped them all, I'll wet my hands and roll them smooth before placing them in the freezer.
When I cook the meatballs, sometimes I pre-cook them and then bag them. And other times I will freeze them raw and they'll get cooked before they are served. So these ones I'm going to freeze raw. And we will probably cook them with either a tomato-based sauce, so like spaghetti and meatballs, and probably in the Instant Pot for a quick, easy meal, because half the prep work is now done. Once we've done a big day like today, dinners in the future become very easy because half the work is done. And that's why I do it. That's why I do these big cook-up days. And that's why I'm showing you, so that your future self can thank you. So I'm just using this ice cream cookie scoop, and then I'll roll them and I'll freeze them on a tray. Once they're frozen, I'll pop them into a bag. A Ziploc bag and keep them in the freezer. So I'll either make a spaghetti type sauce, tomato based sauce, or I might make Swedish meatballs with a creamy gravy and mashed potatoes. Depends what we feel like at the time that we go to eat them. A tip for rolling meatballs: have wet hands. So I've just wet my hands with water and be gentle and just roll them. Done. These are now headed for the freezer before we will bag them up. Thank you for hanging out with me today.
I hope that today's freezer meals have inspired you to have a go at maybe filling your freezer and seeing how long you can help yourself out in the future. Today's meals will last us about a month, if not more. And that's with eating fresh meals in between that I make when I feel like cooking at night. But sometimes we all just need a break, and this is me giving myself a break in the future. Watching today, I hope that you enjoyed today's freezer cook-up. Feel free to subscribe if you like this kind of video. I have some more canning food preservation videos coming soon. And thank you for being you. Thanks for being here, and I look forward to bringing you another video soon. I don't even know what to say. I'm gonna have to fill the dishwasher, and I guess that's my plan for the afternoon. Anyway, thanks for coming by.